Okay, children, a very good morning to all of you. Children, in the previous class, we were discussing about different algebraic identities, and I had discussed three main identities, namely your a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, and a square minus b square. What is their formula? What are those identities? We had discussed in the last class. Okay, now there are two more identities left as per your syllabus. So let us complete these two identities and then we will discuss the application of different algebraic identities. Okay. So after the third identity, let us see what is the fourth algebraic identity. The fourth algebraic identity is, it is the product of two binomials. See, look at x plus a, this is one binomial, x plus b is another binomial. Now what will be the product of these two binomials? The product will be this. X square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. So this is also one of the identities. You will find its application later while we will discuss problems. Okay. So let us prove it. It is very simple. You can easily multiply the two binomials. Now see, if you break x plus a into x plus b, the LHS, then you multiply x by the second binomial, first term of this binomial by the second binomial, and second term of the first binomial by the second binomial. That means what will I write? I will write x into x plus b plus a into x plus b. Okay. That means each term of the first binomial will be multiplied by the second binomial. Okay. So now this will be equal to, you see, x into x is x square plus bx plus ax plus a into b ab. Now see, these two are like terms, okay? Ax and bx, you see, having common x, x can be taken common out of these two terms, you can take x common. So if you take x common, what you will get? You will get x square plus b plus a or a plus b, whatever you write, into x plus abc. So the proof is very simple. So, now see, here both a and b are positive, but if one of the terms is negative, suppose a will be negative and b positive, or b negative, a positive, or both a and b negative, okay, then the sign only the sign will change, okay. What will be that, we will discuss in problem, okay. So, you remember this identity, whose application you will find just after the class, all the identities are discussed, how this identity, where, in which kind of problems we will apply this identity, I will discuss later, okay. Now see, then what is the fifth identity? This is the last identity given as per your class 8 syllabus. See, what is the third identity? Fifth identity. The fifth identity is about the square of a trinomial. You see, children, you know what is a trinomial. It is an algebraic expression having three terms. See, it has three terms, namely say A, B and C. Now let us see what will be the square if you expand. If you expand this trinomial, okay, if you find the square of this trinomial, what will be its expansion? The expansion will be your a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 into ab plus bc plus ca. Or instead of writing 2 into ab plus bc plus ca, you can write plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. It is same, okay. I have just taken 2 as a common factor. Let us see whether this identity is true or not. Okay, let us prove it. Okay, and how to prove? You prove by breaking the LHS. You can easily break the LHS and find the RHS. See, the LHS is a plus b plus c whole square. So what does it mean? It means the trinomial a plus b plus c will be multiplied how many times? Two times. So multiply. It will be a plus b plus c into a plus b plus c. Okay. Now, multiply A by the whole trinomial, that means A into A plus B plus C plus second B, B again multiplied by the second trinomial A plus B plus C, then the third term is plus C. It will again be multiplied by the third trinomial. So now you can easily multiply because it is a monomial and it is a trinomial, and you know how to multiply a monomial by a trinomial. So a into a square ab plus ac plus b into a ab plus b square plus bc plus ca plus bc plus c square. You see. Now rearrange the terms. A square, here is b square, here is c square. So rearrange a square plus b square plus c square. You see. a square plus b square plus c square. Now look at, here is AB, here is AB. AB and AB, these are like terms, so they will be added. Because we know like terms are added, subtracted, multiplied and divided. So as in this expression, there are two like terms, namely AB, so they will be added. Similarly, BC and BC, these are two like terms, they will also be added. And your AC and CA, they are also like terms, they will be added. So what we will get? We will get 2AB plus 2BC plus 2CA. Now, out of these three terms, 2AB, 2BC and 2CA, we can take 2 as the common factor. So you take common 2. So what will you get? You will get A square plus B square plus C square plus 2 into AB plus BC plus CA. Okay. So, see, in this way, we proved that this identity is true. That is, square of A plus B plus C equal to square of A plus square of B plus square of C plus 2 into, you see, the sum of the products of AB, BC and C. Okay. So, these are different algebraic identities. Okay. So, now we will see how they are applied. Okay, children, from this identity we can derive some more. You see, from this identity we can derive some other sub identities. What are the sub identities? Let us see which can be derived from this. Okay. Now see, children, suppose you are given, see, if A plus B plus C whole square, look at, if A plus B plus C whole square equal to A square plus B square plus C square plus 2 into AB plus BC plus CA, then what will be the value, what will be the formula for A square plus B square plus C square? You see, some sub identities. Let me discuss some sub identities. Okay, sub identities. So the first sub identity, you find the value of A square plus B square plus C square. What will be the formula for A square plus B square plus C square? Because children, if you remember this, you can easily find the problem. You can apply it easily in the problems and find. I will discuss the problem also relating to all identities as well as sub-identities. Okay. See. So what will be the formula for A square plus B square plus C square? Look at, if A plus B plus C whole square equal to this plus this, then definitely A square plus B square plus C square will be equal to how much? Just you take this expression. Take this expression 2 into AB plus BC plus CA to the left hand side. And here it is added. If it goes to the left hand side, it will be subtracted. That means the formula for this will be A plus B plus C whole square minus 2 into AB plus BC plus CA. And what is the importance of this identity or this formula? Let us see. What is the importance? Let me tell you here. What is the importance? The importance of this sub-identity or this formula is that when the value of C, suppose in a particular question, you are given the value of A plus B plus C. I am just giving one example so that you will understand. See, let us see how this identity is applied. Okay, how this sub-identity is applied. See, suppose A plus B plus C, the value of A plus B plus C is given. Suppose 10. And you are also given the value of AB plus BC plus CA. Say it is 5. Suppose the value of A plus B plus C is 10 and the value of AB plus BC plus CA is 5. And what you are asked to find the value of A square plus B square plus C square. The question is, find A square plus B square plus C square. What is the value? How to find out? How to find out this one? To find this one, we can use directly this formula. We can use this sub-identity or this formula directly to find the value of A square plus B square plus C square. You see, you can easily find, you put. Now, what is the formula? A plus B plus C whole square. Now, what is the value? 10. So, it is 10 square minus 2 into AB plus BC plus C. What is the value? 5, you see. So, this will be 90. 100 minus 10, it will be 90. See. I could directly find the value of A square plus B square plus C square when the values of A plus B plus C and AB plus BC plus C are given using this sub-identity or formula. Children, I hope you understood. Okay. Now, similarly, how to calculate the value of this? Look at. Directly, how to calculate the value of AB plus BC plus CA if the value of A plus B plus C, look at, if the value of A plus B plus C and the value of A square plus B square plus C square are given. How will you calculate directly the value of AB plus BC plus CA. There is another formula or another sub identity. So what is that? Let us see. The next sub identity is, you see, the next sub identity is your the value of AB plus BC plus CA. AB plus BC plus CA. How can we find out AB plus BC plus CA? It will be A plus B plus C what? Whole square. You see, to find the value of this, we have to remember this formula. The main identity. What is the main identity? I told you. It is A plus B plus C whole square equal to A square plus B square plus C square plus 2 into AB plus BC plus CA. Okay. Now, we want to find the value of this AB plus BC plus CA. So, what will we do? First, we will take this expression. Look at. This expression must be taken to the left hand side. And you see here it is added in the right hand side. So, if it goes to the left hand side, it will be subtracted. And 2 is multiplied means 2 will be divided C. So, the value of AB plus BC plus CA will be equal to, you see what will be the formula? It will be A plus B plus C whole square minus A square plus B square plus C square divided by 2. See? Okay. A plus B plus C whole square minus A square plus. That means if you are given the values of A plus B plus C and A square plus B square plus C square, you can easily compute the value of AB plus BC plus CA using this formula. So what you will do? What is the whatever is the value of A plus B plus C, take the square. Okay, I am giving one example so that you will understand. Okay, so see one example. Suppose A plus B plus C equal to say 6 and A square plus B square plus C square equal to say 4. Then what will be the value of AB plus BC plus CA? You can easily find. If A plus B plus C is 6 and A square plus B square plus C square is 4, we can easily compute the value of AB plus BC plus C. How? By using this identity or this sub identity or this formula. So A plus B plus C whole square means 6 square minus the value is 4 you put divided by 2. It is 36 minus 4 by 2. It will be 16. 32, yes. The value of AB plus BC plus C will be 16. See. So, using this sub identity, we could find the value. Okay. So, children, with this, we completed all the 5 algebraic identities as given in your syllabus and some sub identities also. Okay. So, in the next class, we will discuss the application of all these identities. I hope whatever I discuss, children, you understood. Okay. Thank you.